Welcome to the Signal Box Museum that's situated on the ground floor of the Signal Box. Okay, before we go in, we'll just have a look at the items out here. We've got a big array of permanent way equipment, tools and various things, including a track drill there. And we've also got the two of the Elstree Tunnel signs. Elstree Tunnel is located between Elstree and Mill Hill stations. We've got one sign that we've restored and one sign that's in as found condition. So now if we go inside, this is the ground floor of the signal box, which in most cases is called the locking room, because in most signal boxes the interlocking between the levers, the signals and the points, all the equipment was located on the ground floor. In the case of the Midland Railway, which built this signal box, all the interlocking is actually upstairs with the levers. And the only thing that would be down here in the locking room are a series of these linkage arms that link the levers upstairs with the wires and the rods going out to the signals and the points. There's 44 levers upstairs, and we've kept this bank of a dozen or so levers just to show you how it was. Each one that operated would have a counterbalance weight on the end. This one operates the signal in the garden, lever 32. Okay, now we'll move into the main part of the museum from the lobby to have a look at some of the items in here. The Trust has been very fortunate that once we are started to open to the public, we will offer lots and lots of items of railway honour for display, and we've gradually filled up the room here. One of our prize exhibits is a video that was taken of the signal box operational in 1979, so that we can show our visitors what it was like in real time to operate the signal box. And this is normally on display when we're open. And if we have a look around at some of the items here, this is a British Railway poster from the early 1950s that was designed by Terence Cuneo, one of the great railway painters. And if we move along on the shelf, you'll see there's lots of lamps. We like our lamps, some of which are operational, others are on display. The railway had all sorts of uses for lamps of all shapes and sizes. We've got a number of block instruments around on the shelf here. One or two of the bells are linked up so that our visitors can actually play with the bells and pretend to be signalmen. We've got a Gauge 1 model here that was donated to us by one of our members, a model of a Midland compound, which was a type of steam locomotive that would have regularly worked past this signal box in the days of steam. Among some of the items that we've got here, more modern one, this is a Westinghouse demonstration panel of more modern signalling than the semaphore signalling that operated from the box here. And this was used to show the type of signalling that is now in use on this line. It's very simple and shows the passage of a train from one signal. Allows the train to come past and move on to the next signal. Very simple, but was used to demonstrate the principles. This was donated to the Trust by the National Railway Museum at York. On the wall here, we've got more lamps and repeaters, most of which are located in a set of pigeonholes that came from the old St Albans station when it was redeveloped in the 1970s. At the far end here, we've got a photographic display. We put on different displays at different times, of largely concentrating on the railways around St Albans. Our current display illustrates the railways to the north, the south and the station itself, recording 150 years of the Midland Main Line through St Albans. Up on the wall here, we've got two signalling items. We have the name boards from St Albans North Signal Box, which was about three quarters of a mile further away from the south box on the other side of the station. And to the south was Knapsbury station and Knapsbury signal box. And we have a diagram there from the signal box, and that's the final design before the closure in 1979. It still shows the platform there, although that had disappeared at that time. We have another signal box diagram there, much simpler one, from Esholt Junction, which is in West Yorkshire, but was also a Midland Railway box. We've got two Tyer's number six single line equipment, and we've got a separate demonstration of that for you coming up in a moment. If we move round the box here, a lot of the display items here are original pieces of furniture that were left in the signal box when we took it over. We've painted them and made them smarter and used them for displaying various models and smaller items of railway honour. Up at the top there we have another signal box diagram, this time not from the Midland. This is Hatfield number two, which was at the north end of Hatfield station, and actually has the exit for the St Albans branch showing on the diagram. Below that we have another signal box diagram and a shelf of instruments here, donated to us some years ago by the National Railway Museum at York. And when we got it here and worked on it, we discovered that it came from the Waterloo and City line, and the signal box was actually on the platform down below at Waterloo prior to it being upgraded and handed over to London Transport. In the cupboard here we've got a display of lamps. Again, various uses for the lamps. We don't have operational lamps in the signal box here from a fire precaution point of view, but outside when we're open we have a number of lamps on display showing the different uses of the lamps. We have a number of items of merchandise for sale to raise funds to the upkeep of the box. We also have a number of railway books that are generously donated by some of our visitors that are available for sale, again to generate funds for the upkeep of the signal box.
So this is about signalling on a single line, where trains have to go both directions on the single line. So we need some additional authority for the driver to be on the single line, so we only have one train going one direction at a time. A simple case of this is on an elongated siding, so you just go out and come back again, and you have a train staff. And you give this to the driver, and there's only one of them, and if he has it, then no one else can come on the single line. Where you have a through line, say in Scotland or parts of Wales, where trains might go from one single line to another, then you need something a bit more sophisticated, and that's where we have these so-called Tyer's number six instruments. Mr. Tyer was a designer of, amongst other things, single line instruments, and was trying to stay one step ahead of devious signalmen to keep these things safe. So the principle of this system is that we have a token to give to the driver, and in this case it's a steel tablet which we can give to the driver, and this is an example of one. We get one out of the machine, and there's a pile of them in these windows here. Once a tablet is out of the machine, then it locks the system, because you can only by definition have one out at a time, one train on the single line. So if we're going from A to B, B needs to give permission, and we do that by pressing and holding in this button here and turning the commutator there. So this has now released this machine, and I just do one to acknowledge, and if we can see the indication here, there's out at the bottom there and out at the top there, which is indicating that the system is locked. There's a tablet out, and it comes out of this drawer here, and this is the tablet that we give to the driver, and we give it to the driver in this leather pouch, which we then hold up to the driver, and he catches it over his arm like this. I think these days the driver tends to stop, and they're handed over with a train stationery. So we're going from here to here. So I'm the driver now surrenders this tablet to the signalman at this end of the line, and we can get an empty drawer, a bit stiff, and we put the tablet in there, and then it goes in and latches inside here in this pile of tablets. So now we have an empty drawer, it's locked inside. So this instrument at this end still has a draw out, and it can't go back in yet because we need to release it from this system. So we hold this plunger in again, turn that back there, and then that allows that to go back in, and we lock it in, and then just acknowledge, and we're back to where we started. So that's a simple illustration how we go from A to B by using the tablet. The other beauty of this system is there's a pile of tablets in each machine, so if we have a series of trains going in one direction, we don't run out of tablets. It's not as though we need to go one way and then back the other way. We can have several going one way before anything goes back.